Good evening. I'm going to have another try. And get the sound right. My YouTube podcast. Yeah, went terribly wrong the first time. Okay, the first thing I've done is I've soaked the reverse side of the paper. Yeah. I want this to be sort of gradual realization, and so I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do until you'll see as it gradually emerges. I just want this reverse side of the paper nice and soaking wet. So I'm going to let that soak in for a little bit. Okay, so it goes nice and like a prawn cracker. The colours I'm using are colours I've used on a previous picture, and I can't even remember all of them. They're all cadmium something or other. Apart from a really dark shadow violet that is going to hopefully make some nice strong effects in the middle. Right, give that a little shake, turn it round, and we're going to soak it again. Another thing is I'm going to try and get it done in under 40 minutes. Give this side. Now, the paper I'm using is Bockingford watercolour paper. And the reason why I like this is it's actually cold pressed, or also called not. Yeah, I'll tell you what pounds it was, but I can't remember. And it's got a knobbly surface, which is what cold pressure really means. Yeah, got some shadows on the picture from my tripod. I am going to get some better equipment. I'm going to get some microphones and that kind of thing once lockdown is over. Yeah, let that soak in for a bit, and it is June 3rd, in the evening. It's been raining all day. I don't mind. Don't mind a bit of rain. And I'll just get some paint together. And this is what lying around, which is a combination of cadmium orange, and that might be vermilion, or it might be bright orange. Okay. Let the paper soak in for a little bit longer. We'll get some more colours. I think this is cadmium scarlet red. Got bits in it because I'm untidy and I'm not going to whisper. Okay, look at that. Nice and creamy, beautiful. Right. I'm ready. Pop some of this in the middle. which is also a nice Daniel Smith colour. I'm not going to use every one of these. I shall discard some of them so as not to. I should also clean my brushes from every now and again. Okay, here we go. Pick that up. Try and get rid of the novels, if that's even a real word. And all this paper flat, and I've got it propped up a little bit. So straight down. You see that okay? Use my little finger's balance and I'm just going to pop that on. Do it again. And again. Put this in the middle now. I want it a little bit chewier than that. I'm going to drop that. Seesaw's just gone from the picture. I do not want that, he said clearly. Right. This brush in my hand I use all the time. It's called an extended point. Oops. Do that again in the middle. Repeat what I just said. I'm going to do that again in the middle. here. I actually pointed to it and I said, I'm going to use that. Oh, I found it. I'm going to do this bit straight away because it's not going to work that well. Do this instead. I want it to tumble down there a bit, but not too much. Here we go. We haven't got all day, so I think I'm just going to go in with this colour. Very good. Right. So, what I've done is I've planted loads of these things in the garden. And there are several different varieties. So let's try. Okay. I'm going to go back to this one because I'm not 100% happy with it. Let it soak in for a bit. Paper's a lot wetter in the middle. Key with this, right? The paper should want it to go there. Fill off my brush. It's soaking in. Meaning the paint doesn't get so diluted. It's not going to dribble as far. Time is it? Oh, a lot of water in there. The first circle I did went very, very well. And it's all been downhill since then. Add something else to my psychedelic jellyfish. Paper's too wet. I've been too keen to get going that I've not let the paper dry enough. Well, it's dry at all, but it's soaking enough. I'll be with you in a second. And here we go again. I was just about to straighten the paper now. Took a bit of steam now. Watch that for a second. I think I'm going to put the dark area in there, since I've allowed it to dry a lot more than that, or soak in a lot more than that. I'll just chuck my brush down again. Cannot be that far away. Try and make it look like I'm doing it on purpose. If that's that gone. Where I left it. Hiding behind another brush. Going to do is, because that's just decided to dribble there, and pretend that's where I wanted it to go in the first place. Can take some of this excess paint off. I can. I don't want to do it because it's not in keeping with the mindfulness flowy picture malarkey. I'm not going to do it. I'm not. I'm going to do it another way. How long have we got? 7 minutes. One more poppy, or should I? Or just concentrate on the dark bits. Turn him upside down. Yes, there is a right way and a wrong way. And I think I'm going to try this again. Straight in the middle there. And just there. And bit more of this for balance. Makes sense. I'm just saying these words because they sound arty. Let's hope the sound has worked. Anybody who does watch this, thank you very much for watching. If you see it on Facebook post or anything there, please do go to my YouTube and subscribe. I think that's the word. Because even though there's not an awful lot happening at the moment, there will be. Because I'm going to be doing a couple of these a day. Thank you so much for putting up with me if the sound was rubbish. Or better put it the right way up, hadn't I? I do apologise. I like that. Randomness. Thank you very much and TTFM.